Hello, my name is Mark Sabatella, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you the new automatic placement features of MuseScore 3. Automatic placement allows MuseScore to avoid collisions and overlaps between elements, which is something it really didn't do before. So let's take a look at this score, where you can see that I have a tempo marking here at the beginning, and I'm going to add a rehearsal mark over here in the third measure. I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut Control M. And I'll enter a rehearsal mark. Now, you can see based on the height of this rehearsal mark that if I entered one over here, it would overlap the tempo marking. But let's see what actually happens. When I press Control M, you can see it adjusted the height so that this rehearsal mark is actually above the tempo marking. It avoided the collision automatically. Now, you can also adjust the position of things yourself if you want to resolve the collision. For instance, if I move the tempo marking to the side, when I let go, the rehearsal mark can come back down. Or if I press Control R to reset this, I can just turn off automatic placement and let them overlap. And now that they overlap, I can see that maybe the best solution is just to move this one to the left. So you can resolve the collisions yourself if you prefer. Now there's more to it than this also. Let me go ahead and add a crescendo over the first couple of measures. And I'm using the shortcut, the less than sign, which looks like a crescendo. So you can see this crescendo starts right underneath that note, which is normal. If I now add a dynamic marking to that first note, you can see that the crescendo actually moved to get out of the way of that dynamic marking. Now let's look at the staff below. This dynamic marking is getting awful close to that staff below. If I select these notes and transpose them up an octave, you can see that MuseScore has automatically added additional space between the staves to avoid that collision as well. Now for this, there's also an override here in the Breaks and Spacers palette. You can use a staff spacer fixed, and I could drag this to the measure and then double click it and drag the staves back closer together, and that will allow them to overlap if you really want. Normally you wouldn't want that, but this just shows that you have the ability to close up that space again. So those are some of the automatic placement features in MuseScore 3.